Hey, this is Jonas from the Maxon training team, and in this Cinema 4D quick tip, I want to show you how you can render Pyro. First of all, you need to know that Cinema 4D's standard and physical renderers are not capable of rendering fire and smoke. So we have to switch to a renderer that is actually capable of rendering volume data. And the only renderer that is shipping with Cinema 4D that is capable of doing that is Redshift. So let's switch to Redshift. And this will enable us to render Pyro. Now, the next thing you need to know is that this simulation here only exists within the simulation scene, and we cannot directly render it because the volume data is not available in the scene or for rendering. So we need to make this volume data available. And we can do that by selecting the Pyro object. And then you can see in the object tab that we have these volume grids that we can export or make available. And we need density for the smoke and temperature for the fire in this case. And we don't need velocity. You would need velocity to render motion blur, but I don't want to do that for now. All right, now we can go with two options. Either we really export the whole sequence, and this is actually what I would recommend, or you can make the data directly available here in the scene. And for this, you would have to switch both to on, and then the Pyro object would have the volume data in here. You can see that when you move this Pyro object to the side, then you can see that we have two volumes here. This is the actual simulation, and this is the volume grid that we can render. Let me undo this and let me switch these back to on export, because this is actually the way I would recommend. But on export means that we have to cache the sequence. So let's go to cache, and in this case we just hit the cache scene button. We can set a name for the cache. Let's call it Pyro for now, and just hit save. And now it will cache the simulation, and depending on the complexity of your simulation, this can take a little longer. And also be aware of the fact that cached simulations can be quite huge on the hard drive. All right, now that the caching is finished, you can see that the cache has been linked into the Pyro object, and it's also using the cache because enabled is ticked. All right, and now we can just scrub through the timeline and see the whole simulation that we created, and we can render this. By the way, on the drive, caching would create a vol folder with all of these VDBs in there. All right, now let's continue rendering this. And the next thing we need is a material. So let's go to the material manager. Let's open it up and let's just create a material, which is a Pyro volume. And the advantage of the Pyro volume over the volume is that it directly works with Pyro by default, because it has all of the important fields pre-populated with the correct names of the volume grids. Like for scatter, we are using the density grid, and for emission, we're using the temperature grid. If you want to use another grid in some of the other channels, you can always click the presets button here, and then you go to the Pyro object entry, and here you would find all of the grids that are available within the volume data. All right, now let's assign the volume material to the Pyro object and close the material manager. And now if I render this, you can see that Pyro is rendering. Maybe we could add a light, so let me stop the rendering for now, and let's just create another infinite light, and let's make it so that it's coming from the side, like so. Let's start the viewport IPR again, and here we go. This is how you render Pyro. Thanks for watching. If you enjoy our quick tips, please like, comment, and subscribe.